This is a crop with many names. It's known as fava bean, faba bean, broad bean, horse bean. But it is this distinctly vertical legume crop, very different than most legumes, gray-green leaves, and distinct leathery pods. It's considered to be a very highly productive crop and a nutritious one as well. The place of origin is assumed to be the Fertile Crescent region of the Eastern Mediterranean. The biggest producers would be China and Ethiopia. It's grown somewhat here in the US, but it's basically not a well-known crop. Okay, so very heavy leathery pods, which contain the very large size beans. Look at the size of those. Pods have 3 to 8 beans. And in order to eat these, the seed coat has to be removed. For fresh beans, if you plunge these in boiling water, the seed coat will slip off much more easily than I'm showing here. But there is the broad bean. So these can be eaten at the very young stage. The whole pod can be eaten. They are also shelled at the green stage like this, or they can be eaten at the completely dried stage. Now, even though it's a very nutritious crop, some individuals suffer from a condition known as favism. It's a metabolic disorder where individuals lack an enzyme that metabolizes two glycosides known as visine and convisine. The result can be an anemia condition. Fortunately, there have been, after evaluating a large number of accessions, some very low visine and convisine genotypes have been identified and markers developed and cultivars released, mostly in France and Germany. So even though fava beans are not a major crop in the US now, they could be in the future. They're a cool season adapted crop, so planted very early in the spring, or in some regions like the Northwest, they can actually be planted in the fall and grown through the winter. So keep your eye out for fava beans next time you go shopping.